Florence and, well, the XX on the remix of Florence. Hi to everyone on the text. Hi to Scott, the trucker in Perth. Thanks for getting in touch. Hi to Elizabeth in South Wales, who's love listening. Thank you. Thank you to Glyn. Saying good luck, Grimmy. Thank you, Glyn. Hi to Julie as well. Saying Jesus, Grimmy, I'm welling up here. Same. Same. Julie in Whitstable's never even met my mum. How do you think I feel? Oh. Sending me over. Also, lovely message, mum, but I'm obsessed with my mum's radio voice. Well, I thought she was on Radio 4. Hello, it's mother here.
She's a natural.
She is. She's on Women's Hour, can't she? All right, we're going to... We've only got 10 minutes left, so we're going to do a song in a minute. But it's a 5-minute song I'm ending on. So,
I feel a bit sick.
I feel a bit sick. But it's good, you know? It's good. Fee, thank you for joining me. Thanks for being there for Brekkie every single morning. Thank you to everyone who I've ever worked with. All my producers, Matt Fincham and Ian and Fifi and Tina DeHealy from Brekkie. Thank you to Travis, who's been producing today and looking after us today. And the wonderful Sophie Ellis, who we love, who's just a genius. But yeah, thanks so much. And thank you, Fifi. And I just want to say to Fifi as well, thank you so much for the night before our very first breakfast show, coming straight through from Ibiza to the show. It really set a tone for my Radio 1 career.
You're so welcome. But I really want to say thank you, and thank you from behalf of millions of listeners for making everybody smile on a daily basis. If you weren't already aware, Grim is the nicest guy ever. Annoyingly, what you hear on the radio is exactly how he is, kind of all the time. And you can be relied upon for like a really good party, but you're also the greatest friend, like really the greatest friend. You call people up when you know they're having the worst day, and you're also there when you're like, let's get a pint. But I can kind of be really nice to you another day. But the main thing I really want to say to you is that you are the best broadcaster on the radio. You make it all sound so easy, but it's not. And I really hope that this isn't the last time that we'll hear you kind of gassing away for 4.5 hours.
Long one today.
Yeah, kind of CCing there, Chris Evans. You have, of course, done some of your finest work on Very Little Sleep. You are the mastermind behind the Straight Through crew. Mm-hmm. Whatever has gone down the night before, you've always turned up with coffees and a massive hug. But I'm not going to lie, you haven't made it easy for everybody all the time. Do you remember the time you accidentally took sleeping tablets at 7 a.m?
Yeah, that thought it was a vitamin C tablet.
Yeah, you do. It's as an all-be night, rose-tinted glasses. Mm-hmm. And all the guests that come on your show are here because they trust you. You're not interested in any of the fake stuff, and you make every single call on the phone feel like your best friend. And you just love talking to people, and that's what it's all about.
Thank you so much, Fifi.
Love you.
We've had the best time. Obviously, I want to thank you for being here. I just want to thank all the listeners, really. I just want to thank you. You know, this is why we're all here. This is, you know, why we want to do it is for you guys. And you make it so much better. You make our shows better. You contribute every day, and you provide us with sort of endless hilarity and stories of your life. And also, I really appreciate this endless, ruthless opinion as well, which we love to hear. And you're all mad for it as well. As we were saying before, like, you're so up for it. And I will always appreciate that. You know, it really was my childhood dream to work here. And you made that dream come true. Like, you really, really did. And I just want to say something. I really hope it doesn't come across as patronizing, because I really don't. I don't mean it to do. But it was my childhood dream, and I nearly talked myself out of it. And I nearly was like, oh, I can't do that. And I thought that wanting to work here was like, I remember saying, like, it's like going to go and be an astronaut. I want to go and be a footballer. And I remember my family being like, people are astronauts, people are footballers. So it's a really bit of simple advice. And I just wanted to pass it on and just say that, you know, if you do have a dream, you know, don't talk yourself out of it. You know, don't be scared of it. Don't think you don't deserve it, you know, because if I can do it, you can do it. You know, you can do anything you want. So if you do have a dream, I think it's important that you go for it. But listen, I just wanted to as well say how much radio has meant to me, and how, as you were saying, Fee, like, I love radio. I really want to carry on doing radio, whatever it will be. I don't know yet. But growing up, it was just a constant for me. It was a window into the outside world, and it was all the things that I loved, conversation and music, and it still is. And I think radio is so powerful. I always love having like a collective experience and hearing a song together for the first time with you all, and hearing your stories and everyone experiencing the same thing at once is something that I really love. It's such a, I don't know, a simple human thing, but I just don't think it can be beaten. And I think in the past year and a half, we've felt that more than ever in that pandemic. I think we've been more open with you, you've been more open with us, and you know, I felt like we were there for each other. So thank you, seriously, for honestly making my dream come true. And now I've got to play my final song on Radio 1. And it's a song I've never played on Radio 1. And it's a song that was out before I was even born. And last night I was cycling home and I didn't know what to play. It was between two songs. I didn't have to do a silly song. I was going to play Ariana Grande, Thank You Next, but I thought a little flippant. And then as I was cycling home, I'm not even kidding. This song, by the way, is called This Must Be The Place. And there was this is a true story. There was a neon sign in a window that said, this must be the place. So I took that as a literal sign. And this song, for me, I wanted a song that made me, you know, felt special to me, that was full of emotion, that was life-affirming. And you know what? It makes me feel warm, it makes me feel welcomed, and most importantly, just makes me feel. So that's why I wanted to play it. So thank you for listening. Thank you for being part of making my dream come true. I'm honestly, truly thankful. So thank you. Enjoy this. I'll see you around.
Head in. Thank you so much, Grimmy. It's an emotional day at Radio 1. You're an absolute star and you'll be sorely missed. Coming up at 6, it's me, Arlo Parks. I've got a hottest record from Katie B and some very, very special guests. But first, it's time for Newsbeat with Callum Leslie.